provided more than 12 hours of experience in extravehicular activity. The training, the caution, the slow accumulation of facts paid off. Man can work in space. On all Gemini missions, a major objective was to develop re-entry flight path and landing control so the spacecraft could land at a specific place on Earth. This required the development of new techniques for guiding and controlling the re-entry of the spacecraft. This is the view from the spacecraft window as Gemini re-entered the Earth's atmosphere. Glowing particles boiled off the protective heat shield to leave an incandescent wake. During Gemini, 10 manned spacecraft made this fiery re-entry into the Earth's atmosphere. Gemini 12 was the last. Its re-entry in November 1966 climaxed a program which will really have no end. For Gemini is illuminating the future. Of first importance is the fact that Gemini sent more men into space and kept them there longer. Gemini multiplied American manned spaceflight experience 37 times.
There it is. Hey. Flight 12, Houston, we've got you on the boom tube. You look good.
Gemini, an open program, helped further promote international cooperation in space. People in other nations not only witnessed Gemini as it happened, but also helped accomplish the program's objectives, showing again the necessity for international cooperation in the peaceful exploration of space.
We are 325 miles higher than the old altitude set in July by Gemini 10. The crew remain in this orbit for two revolutions. They look down on Earth with a view never before seen by man. They photograph that view for us with a wide-angle lens. The round curvature of the Earth stands out clearly, and it looks almost like a small globe on a table. Searching for adjectives, astronauts Conrad and Gordon said repeatedly that the sight was fantastic and unbelievable. We can only agree with them.
Can I have an 11? Okay, everything can go up here, and the world is round.
You got a good view?
I mean, it's spectacular. Girl, it's really fantastic. You wouldn't believe it.
Over everything hangs a vivid blue color. If there are intelligent creatures in the universe, perhaps they call us the Blue Planet. The flight plan allotted some 3.5 hours to Gemini 11 in this orbit before the command pilot executed a retrograde burn of the Agena PPS. If there are intelligent creatures in the universe, perhaps they call us the Blue Planet. If there are intelligent creatures in the universe, perhaps they call us the Blue Planet. If there are intelligent creatures in the universe, perhaps they call us the Blue Planet.
So the spacecraft would land at a specific place on Earth. This required the development of new techniques for guiding and controlling the re-entry of the spacecraft. This is the view from the spacecraft window of Gemini.